Hello, hello, good evening. It's great to see you. It's great to see you. It's Thursday, of course. This is our weekly time where Thursday Night Guitar, we get together, we play some songs, have a bit of a chat, and we forget about all the rubbish things going on in our lives. We just focus on the good and the guitar. So we're going to do Shania Twain today. It's that don't impress me much. I should know this one because I did transcribe the whole song. But it's yes, it's a really great one. I really hope you enjoy it. As always, it will be recorded for you. We can watch this whole back, and the transcription will be up in full, and of the tabs and the PDF and or all on my website. You can find this. But most importantly, I think it's great that you've picked up your guitar and you're joining in for today because this is a really, really cool song. There's a lot going on in this song in the guitar parts. It's not it's not just a few chords. It is a certainly the lead guitar, which I've put together for us, is certainly interesting. Let's have a go. What we'll do is we'll start with this. And remember, as always, if you've got any questions or anything like this, just chuck them in the chat, but we'll get to it. So it starts off with this really nice and this kind of little line. And by the way, sorry, I probably should have said I didn't say this last week and I forgot. I looked very silly, didn't I? It's a capo on number one. So you need a fret capo on fret number one to make this one work. Otherwise the tabs are in standard tuning, just like you would expect. Okay, so we've got this first little riff and this and in fact, my guitar should be on 10 if I play that. Now, the reason why you can hear that so loud is because I've got a compressor on. And if you didn't know what a compressor, I won't bore you to death, but what it does is it compresses the sound. It brings up the low volume and it brings down the high volume. So it compresses the sound to an equal level. So it means if I put the compressor on here, then when I play this, it doesn't get any quieter, even though you'd expect it if without the compressor. This is without the compressor. It just gets quieter and quieter. So that's why I've put that on there. So in fact, to be honest, you can probably leave the compressor on for the whole song. I think that would be cool. So what do we have? We've got this little thing. So it starts with this. So let's give it a go. Here we go. Really nice little riff there, isn't it? I mean, it's very, very simply just going through that kind of C scale, starting on the note here, and you can kind of play that all along. Probably starting with your ring finger. Yeah, and that's the kind of bit there. Okay. This is what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the next little bit. I want you to do this kind of just look at this without the song, and then you'll hear it coming in. So this bar here. It's coming from, if you think we're kind of in a well, we if we think about the key of D without the capos here, so it's the C shape here, and this kind of shape that we've got here, and then we're going into a G. That's the little thing that we have there. So let me play this right from the very start, and then you'll see what's coming up here. So you probably swap to a clean sound here, so just turn off your drive pedal. So this is going to be clean sound here, yeah? Or cleanish. Okay, now I'm going to play you this, just listen to this and I'll show you what's going on. Okay, I just love that little bit that we've got here. So what have we got here? So, is that don't impress me? So it's a really nice thing, and this is the shape which you really want to get right for this is the, well, this is the good thing to practice. You can see it just written here. It's the C shape. Yes, this is the C shape for the F chord here, yeah? Yeah, F sharp really with the capo, yeah? So what you're doing is you kind of got this. And you're going to bar the fifth fret here, this kind of the major triad there. And then you go into another major triad. So it's kind of like A shape and then E shape like that. So you've got C shape, A, and then E. So we're going. Now, if you can do that, then we've got these little bits. So you can see this thing kind of happens over and over again. Yeah, this little shape. Now, the bit in between it are these kind of variations of it. So the first one's really nice and easy. It's just. And then we have. Remember, it's capo on number one, that's why it looks slightly different. And then for the last one, what we have is. Yeah. And then it's kind of just with those chords again. And then back to the riff. So you want to put on your drive pedal there. Now, what I've written here above, and you can kind of see this, hopefully, says not playing the forehand, change the drive. So on this, on these two bars here, when we go one, and two, and three, and four, change. And that kind of, that forehand, even though we're not playing on the guitar, gives you a chance to change the sound on the instrument. So that's pretty cool. Right, so let's keep going then. Here we go. Let me just play this section one more time, and then we'll go on. We'll go and see what we got coming up next. Here we go. Let's go from the start. Here we go.
I've known a few guys who thought they were pretty smart, but you've got being right down to an art. You think you're a genius, you drive me up the wall. You're a regular original, know-it-all. Okay, so you're a rocket
neck
scientist.
Neck pick up here.
That don't impress me much. So you got the brain.
Now back to the riff that you played before. Now these are really nice, ready? Here we go. Really nice little bit there. So it's just a, I guess something just, it's a, probably what we call an ear tickler. It tickles your ear a little bit, right? So it's just a very, very nice little riff. I'm just walking down the scale, really. Here we go. And then you slide up. And you could go like that. If you were inclined, you could hammer on that one. And then slide with your middle. But I think slide both of them. It sounds cool. And then for the second little bit, very, very, very similar. And it's got vibrato, and then slides off, so. Yeah, really nice little bit. So if I just play this, let's listen to this. Ready? Here we go.
Never knew a guy who carried a mirror in his pocket and a comb up his sleeve, just in case, and all that extra hotel in your hair.
Yeah, really nice. Now we're going to go back to the clean sound that we did earlier. It's the same thing, yeah, but D shape.
Okay,
so now this bit, very similar. That don't impress me much. So you got the looks, but have you got the touch? Now don't get me wrong, yeah, you're all right. But that won't keep me warmer than the middle of the night. Yeah,
really similar bit. I'll just show you this very, very cool bit. I like this bit. So you play that kind of... And then we have, yeah, really nice double stops there. If anyone doesn't know, double stops are playing two strings at the same time. So that's quite cool. I love that bit. Right, and then we're into the solo. I tell you what I'll do is I'll just play this bit one more time, and then I'll play you into the solo, and I'll show you a couple of cool bits from there. Here we go.
Bad pit. That don't impress me much.
I mean, isn't that just wicked, right? So if I slow, we're going to play it slowly for you. Here we go.
That don't impress me
little thing. So I think, I mean, the first I would say this bit, try to finger pick it because you want to get a really clean bend here, and it's that country, it's this kind of sorry, I'm getting a bit of static from my guitar. It's this country bending, isn't it? Yeah, it's the kind of, you want the control on the string. So I think use your fingers there. If you're not used to it, try and start being able to, sorry, I'll just explain this. It's a little bit weird to say, actually, with no context. Try to start holding the pick without really thinking about holding it, if that makes any sense. It doesn't make any sense. I've just heard what I said. When you play... with the pick, it's really great to be able to swap to your fingers while still holding the pick. That's what I'm trying to say. Now, the way that I do this, and this is just how I kind of naturally do this, is I grip it between my middle finger, and that means that I can still kind of play with my fingers if I want to, yeah, and I can just swap to. So try swapping to and fro now and again. This would be really cool. Yeah, this is a really nice little riff here. Yeah, and then it goes on kind of this walking up the pentatonic at the end, that kind of. Yeah, this is the A minor pentatonic, yeah, C major. Obviously, in relation to the kappa, as always, yeah. Really nice little bit. We got those double stops at the end. We got a volume swell coming up, if anyone doesn't know. Volume swell, I must admit, I can't quite get this right on this song. I think it's really a lap still doing it, but you know, we're going to do it like that. So play it just slightly before. Yeah, and then we'll just add that bit in. It kind of going back to this bit again.
Now here is a really nice, yeah, really nice little thing. And this is the pentatonic again, isn't it? It's the A minor. Yeah, C minor, that kind of walking down is really nice. And then it's going to keep going. We've got a really nice, again, it's that same kind of, this bit here is the... Now this, just listen out for this when I play it in a second. It's going. Yeah, and then we got this. It's a really, really nice one. Cool. I reckon what I'm going to do is we're going to play through the whole song, and then we will be able to just talk about what's going on that last little bit. Here we go. Not slowly. Here we go. Let's hear it.
I've known a few guys who thought they were pretty smart, but you've got being right down to an art. You think you're a genius, you drive me up the wall. You're know it all. Okay, so you're a rocket scientist. That don't impress me much. So you got the brains, but haven't got the touch. Now don't get me wrong, yeah, I think you're all right, but that won't keep me warm in the middle of the night. That don't impress me much.
Those runs down. Or the ear ticklers. Goes back to those D shapes.
Okay, so you're Brad Pitt. That don't impress me much.
Probably want a clean sound, ready?
You let me get in. I can't believe you kissed your cup at night. I call you, baby, tell me.
Tickler.
You must be joking, right? I think you're something special. I think you're something else. Okay, so you got a car. That don't impress me much. So you got the moves, but I got the touch.
Stops here. Walk up. Double stops. And then back to the riff. I mean, what a tune that is. What a tune. I've actually on a bit of a, as you can probably tell, we did Shania Twain last week, didn't we? But I'm on a bit of a Shania trip at the moment. So it's got some great guitar in there. Got some great videos coming up to you. I'm sorry it's been so long, but you know, they are being edited as we speak. They've been filmed and edited, and you know, it's I'm really looking forward to bring them to you. I'd like to hear about what you're doing in your playing as well. This would be really cool. Probably a bit less Shania Twain than me, but anyway, it's great to have you here. Remember that the sessions are of course recorded for you. You can watch them back. I know it's a really just a glossing over of this, but you know, it might get you to ask some questions about what's going on, or you know, how can I be able to play this, what should I be practicing, that kind of thing. And those kinds of questions are the ones which I can hopefully answer for you, but I need to know more about you. So anyway, thank you so much for being here, and we will see each other next week for another session. And I hope you have a lovely, lovely rest of the week, and I'll see you very soon. Thank you so much for being here, and we will see each other next week